Audžių, trumpas komentaras jūsų.
Labas vakaras, na, su tarpušvenčiu visus krepšinio mylėtojus pirmiausia norim pasveikinti nuo pieno žvaigždžių, komandos, kolektyvo. O apie pačias rungtynės, taip, dvi pusės, gal taip galima sakyti, pirma tikrai nebloga gynybos prasme, jeigu taip dar nedarytumėm tų tokių grubių klaidų prie bonusų, kur davėm tokių kepšt pražangų, kur įmėtė 12 berods taškų, 13 iš 24 pirmai pusėj baudų metimais. Tai iš vis, sakyčiau, neblogos rungtynės, kaip tokioj stadijoj. Aišku, suprantu ir užjaučiu Kėdainių komandą, nes tikrai išbirėjus ir dabartinė situacija tikrai žaisti, žinau, sunku, nes, sakau, pas mus 10 žaidėjų persirgo ir mes patys matėm, kaip pradėjom treniruotis, kokie mes esam. Ir šiandien matėm tą patį trečiam kelinykai, kai keli žmonės tiesiog po poro sprintų prašosi iš karkeitimo, nes nu, nėra kvapo. Tai tas svarbu, aišku, mums buvo pasiekti pergalę, ją pasiekėm, antra pusė netiek džiugina, norėtumėm iš jaunimo daugiau energijos, čia ne paslaptis, čia gauni ne šiaip palakstyti aikštelį, tu nori įrodyti, kad vertas daugiau minučių, tai toks gal trumpas.
O kada sužinojot, kad Kėdainių komandai negali žaisti 4 svarbų žaidėjai?
Šiandieną.
Pamatėm. Prieš pat rungtynę?
Taip, kalbėjom kažkad kažkas tai liktai nežais, bet žinot, tai ne mūsų darbas klausinėtis ir ieškot, kas nežais, mūsų darbas buvo pasiruošti maksimaliai rungtynėm ir nebūtų įtakoję mūsų darbo, jeigu būtų žaidus pilna sudėtis ar ne, tiesiog. Mes šiuo atveju tikrai važiuodami rungtynę žiūrėjom labiau savęs negu varžovo, tuo labiau, kad žinojom, turi naują trenerį, kad ir jo šiandieną nebuvo, kad bus pakeistas polimas, gal gynyba nesitikėjom, kad bus pakeista, bet polimas žinojom, kad deriniai bus pakeisti, tai buvo daugiau visas akcentas į mūsų pačių asmeninius ir komandinius dalykus.
Gal repetavot kai kurios dalykus gynybai polime, žiūrėdami į ateitį derinius ar gynybos?
Ne, tikrai ne, kad ir atrodo rezultatas gal tą ir leistų padaryti, bet viena paprasta priežastis, kaip minėjau, kai mūsų visa komanda iškrito ir tas 2 savaitės nesportavom, tai mums labai patiems reikėjo daugiau prisiminti, ką turėjom prieš tai, negu kurti kažką tai naują, tai būtent dėl to žaidėm, vadinkim, gal to senuoju bagažu.
O kiek dar maždaug dienų reikia, kad įgautumėt jau tokią optimalią sportinę formą, nu, pirmiausia fizinę formą.
Nežinau, tikrai nespėliosiu, nes pirmą kartą susidurėm su tuo ir tikrai gal kitos komandos, kurios jau išlipo iš tos dobės, galėtų atsakyti. Mes dar tik tai esam toj situacijoje ir matysim. Tikimės, kuo greičiau, tikrai neforsavom žaidėjų, tos pirmosios treniruotės priminė daugiau pasivaikščiojimo parke, tikrai be jokio bėgimo netgi. Ta prasme, tai nebuvo jokio pagreitėjimo pirmas 3 dienas, Tai tikrai kreipiam dėmesį žaidėjų sveikatą ir ačiū klubui, kad turim nuo sezono pradžios poliarus, galim per treniruotės, net keli žaidėjai šiandieną per rungtynės užsidėję juos, stebim jų pulsus ir taip toliau, atsistatymus, tai klubas viską daro, kad žaidėjų sveikatą nerizikuotume.
Ar buvo, kad kai kurie žaidėjai ir sirgo sunkesnė? Forma ar visi taip persirgo lengva forma?
Buvo keli žaidėjai, nevardinsiu gal kas, bet buvo keli žaidėjai, kuriam temperatūra pakankamai aukšta laikėsi ir ne vieną, ir ne dvi dienas. Ir kitas dalykas, vėlgi, sakau, čia kitos irgi komandos tą patį pasakys, nu, kai tu esi savo izoliacijoje su temperatūra, tu sportuoti negali, nu, medikai net nepatarė tau, net tos vadinkim mankštos daryti ar ten gero stretchingo, tai, nes tai yra pavojinga, tai tas pirmą beveik savaitę iš vis buvom be jokio judėjimo.
Well, you know, we knew coming in the game that we were limited with bodies and that I knew personally that it was going to be a struggle for us to score offensively. I was worried about getting over 50, 60 points because I just didn't think we had enough offensive firepower. We only had 2 guys in double figures. Cedric Bearfield had 17. He didn't have a great game. He had 7 turnovers. I mean, it was his first game back after a month. So it was kind of tough. You know, his wind wasn't good. Grantas did a pretty good job. I asked him to get a double-double, and he did. He got 11 points and 14 rebounds. I'm a little surprised. I thought Domas Felice would be able to get us double figures, but he cramped up in the end, but he didn't have a great game. We just, you know, we did too many things wrong to beat a good team. That team right there, they have size, and they're very, very skilled. They all shoot the ball very well. They made 8 threes in the first half. What I like is that at halftime I told the guys, look, we're down 26. We could roll over and lose by 40, or we could battle and fight and try to make it a game, be competitive. And we did that. You know, we won the third quarter by 2. We won the fourth quarter by one. Now, I know that's not saying a lot because you're already down 26, so you end up losing by 23. But you know what? We battled. We made four threes in the, because at halftime, we were 1 for 13 from three, which is 7%. I mean, and we had 10 turnovers. We ended up with 20 turnovers for the game. So if you have 20 turnovers, we ended up shooting 16% from three for the game, 5 for 31. I mean, these numbers, it's, you're not going to beat a good team with those kind of numbers. You're just not. Not in this league. This league is better than people think. All the guys play well together. They're skilled. You know, we just have too many issues right now coming off COVID. We've had back-to-back 14-day quarantines, and we just have too many players out. I mean, I don't want to make excuses, but we really miss Kaza tonight, our captain, because he's our best rebounder. And, you know, like I said, you know, we left too many points on the board. We missed 9 free throws. But again, what we tried to ask him to do was play hard and make it a game and be competitive. And I thought in the second half we did that. In the first half, they hit 8 threes. We didn't do a great job defensively. We have a new coach coming in, and it's been a little hard because I came off quarantine and came in after coaching the last 2 games, and then he was going to take over, but then he went out and he's been in quarantine. So he's been trying to run the team through Zoom, and so we've been trying to put new stuff in. And, you know, it's just hard to do that. You know, we just have to all get everybody back, get on the same page, and get some players back. I mean, we're missing, you know, Kaza, Panos, Ariel, Huck Porty, you know, of course, Abramo, Sanka. We're missing Tamulis. So we're missing, you know, 5 guys, 2 or 3 of them are starters. Mm-hmm. So we just don't have enough firepower right now.
Mm-hmm. And when Huck Porty, Kazakauskas, Tamulis, Kalaidzakis will be back in the roster.
I think sporadically in the next couple weeks, like I believe Panos, we're going to get back pretty soon. He had a broken nose, but he's okay. He got the mask. He got surgery. I believe he's coming back very soon. Ariel, I don't know the exact dates of all these guys, but none of them are that far away. I think Panos and Ariel and Tamulis and I think Kaza has been with us, with the team. Mm-hmm. He hasn't been cleared yet. So I think, like, we're going to get 1 or 2 guys back, like each couple days, you know. Hopefully by January 3rd when we play CBET, we have at least, you know, one of the hard things that's been hard for us is we haven't been able to go 5-on-5 in practice because we haven't even had 10 guys. So we need to get 10 guys so we can compete.
And when David Gale will start his new job as a head coach?
I also think very soon. I think I heard that he's going to be here this week. I'm not sure if it's Wednesday or what day he's going to come, but I believe he'll be here, you know, very soon. We haven't even had a chance to meet each other, even though we're both from the U.S. Mm-hmm. We don't really know each other, so I haven't even had a chance to meet him. But again, right now it's a struggle. I guess in some ways it's probably good just to have a game because we haven't had a game in a month. You know, you never like to just come out and lose, but again, I think we need to play, and hopefully we're going to get better.
Have you met David Gale before in the United States? Did you know him?
No, we knew of each other. I think we both sort of knew each other. I know he was in the G League in Toronto, and I was a college coach then, mm-hmm. NCAA. But we didn't really know each other too well. And then so far, we only saw each other for 2 minutes when we both had to go get a COVID mm-hmm. test. But we really haven't had a chance to really get on the same mm-hmm. page or anything. But, you know, I think that his style that he wants to play is very similar to the way I coach. So hopefully I should be able to help him. You know, like I said, it may take us a while. I don't know if it's going to take us till the end of January or February. I'm not sure when we're going to be, like, together as a team, but it's just been so many changes that I think right now we're still not where we need to be as a team.
Mm-hmm. Can you compare Marius Kiltinavičius and the new coach, David Gale?
It's a good question. I don't know, you know, because I've never worked with David Gale yet.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that, you know, Marius, of course, is a very good coach, and he's also from Lithuania, so I think he knew the league very well, mm-hmm. and he knew the personnel extremely well. Of course, he speaks the language, and he knows the culture. So I think that, you know, that's an adjustment, but that's an adjustment for a guy like me, but it'd probably be an adjustment for David Gale also. But I really can't compare because, you know, I don't really, you know, haven't worked yet with Dave Gale. But I think that eventually our style of play will hopefully match our personnel, because eventually we're going to be able to play more bodies, you know. And right now we just don't have, like I said, we just don't have enough. Mm-hmm.